Hello, Dynamics 365 community. Today we'll be continuing our retail series for Dynamics 365 Finance and Operation. We will be discussing omni-channel retail functionality that was previously released. I want to focus on the fact that this feature is under previous release, so my expectation was for this to work outside of the box right away without any additional configuration. However, it wasn't that easy to set it up, and I'll get into more details as we go. So let's start with the first feature, ability to create an order in-store POS that allows fulfillment from any warehouse. So to achieve this transaction, you have to go to the inventory lookup, select your item. In our case, I'm going to select it from Miami. And I will click ship product. So from here, I can select our ship to, which is our store, and ship from, which is the warehouse that we've selected. I can select shipping charge, set this today date, and then I can add the customer. So I will add the customer. So the system is telling me that delivery method must be selected. So I'm going to select standard. Well, this is for our second line. And I'm going to click pay cash. I'm going to make it a full. So this was the transaction that would allow you to do a ship from one warehouse to your store and then fulfill that order later once it's received. So in the previous version, if you don't have all the updates installed, you can still achieve that functionality. And now, if I do, I'm gonna repeat the transaction quickly. If you don't install any updates recommended by Microsoft, ship product button is not available. So you can kind of trick the system and still achieve this functionality. To do that, you use the same form, you select your product, and instead of ship product, you select pick up and store. The system will default the warehouse, a pick warehouse, as a warehouse selected from here. So I'm gonna click pick up and store, custom order. Please note, this will not work in my updated version, but it will work in the previous versions. So now, instead of doing a pickup, you would click ship selected, and what the system will do in this case, the system will ship this item from a warehouse selected in a previous form, and it will ship it to the retail store that you're currently logged in, which is just another way to make it work without updating your system. So moving back, new hybrid order capability that lets a customer place an order for items to be fulfilled later while carrying out other items, all part of the same transaction. So the idea here is pretty simple. You're able to invoice part of your sales order that was created from a POS, and the other lines will remain open. So I'm gonna quickly demonstrate this functionality to you. The scenario is pretty straightforward. I'm gonna add one product. Then I'm gonna select another product. I'm gonna add sunglasses to this transaction. I'm gonna click add item. I'm gonna go back to my screen here. So from here, what I will do, I'm gonna say that the first line will be picked up on a later day, and it will be picked up from Chicago. I'm gonna click and set as a date, October 31st. So you'll see that under delivery, we have a pickup date, which is in the future. And for the first line, I'm gonna say that I'm gonna carry out selected. That means I'm gonna invoice the second line right away. Before I can finalize the order, I'll need to select the customer for my pickup. I'm gonna add the customer to the transaction, and I will pay the order in full. So once the payment is completed, I will switch back to all sales orders. And I will show you the latest transactions that we've done. And you can see that the first line has the status open order, and the second line was directly invoice and pickup from the store. So this is the functionality in a nutshell. So the third feature here is improved order search experience that allows new options for an associate to look up, retrieve orders placed by customer. So this is straightforward too. You just click the find order functionality and you have additional filters that were introduced in this release. So I'm not gonna focus too much time on here. So here's an interesting part. Ability for an associate to create an order for customer who chooses the store the order will be shipped from at the time of order creation, also known as charge send. Since this functionality is under previous release, I assume that the feature is already available in the V10 release of Dynamics 365. I spent a couple of days and I wasn't able to make it work. The functionality just did not appear anywhere in the POS. I tried Cloud PS, I tried regular PS, it wasn't there. So finally, we decided to send an email to Microsoft support, and the reply message that we got from Microsoft basically is this: for this feature to work, we need to install the following updates. One would be your X++ update, and the second one would be your binary update for your finance and operation. So I was able to download the binary update. There is a really good video by Lachlan Cash on how to install binary updates, and I will provide the link for this video in the description. So for the X++ update, it's pretty straightforward too. Kudos to Microsoft. They made it really easy for us non-technical users to install these updates. So to install the update, you have to open your Visual Studio under Dynamics 365. Button on the top, you click Add-ins, then you select your Apply Hotfix. You have to specify the file. After clicking Apply, you have to wait for a minute or two for the update to be applied. So this is straightforward. So I followed the Microsoft suggestion and I installed the retail both updates here. However, installing updates did not resolve my issue. I assume that during the binary retail update 2 installation, I had some error messages, so I maybe that what causes the update not to be reflected in my modern POS. So I almost gave up on making this feature work. And then I've noticed that Microsoft released another update for retail update 3, which is the update you would install for your retail essentials that you previously had in Dynamics 2012. Now it's called Dynamics 365 for Retail. Just to try it, I decided to give it a go and install this update version 3, and ship send feature got enabled after the retail update 3 was successfully installed. So this is my story on how I got this to work. I was not able to find any material online how to use this functionality. So here's the quick overview how the feature works. So once you get your updates installed from here, and I assume if you do it right with no errors, just to install those two updates will work for you. You don't have to install the retail 3. So I'm gonna create a transaction quickly. I'm gonna select our 111 item. And now I'm gonna select my line. I'm gonna click ship selected, custom order. And here you'll see that this feature here, this part of the form that I'm hovering my mouse, or this is new ship from. Before it was not available, only ship to was available. So now you're able to change origin. So I'm gonna click change origin, and I'm gonna have all these warehouses and fulfillment center to ship this product from. So I'm gonna select Austin. I'm gonna click. So you'll see that the Austin is shipped from. For ship to, I'm gonna pick my customer. So here it is. Once I do that, I'm gonna select my shipping method. I'm gonna select my shipping charge. Ship as today date. I'm gonna pay by cash. Let's do full. So if we go back to our all sales orders form, the latest transaction that you'll see will have a Austin ship from warehouse, and as a delivery address, it's gonna have the customer address. So, really nice addition to the omnichannel retailing that Microsoft is trying to implement. However, to make it work, it took me some time. So, hopefully, in the future, for you future Dynamics 365 users, in a month or two, you're gonna have a stable release, so you don't have to go through all the updates to make this work. As usual, drop a line in the comments if you want to see any other functionalities that Microsoft is releasing. Again, please subscribe. Thank you, and until next time.